Good day, fellow investors. We discuss a lot of investing theory on this channel, and I wanted to make it more practical by making a weekly recap of the stock market and investing news that we can apply the theory on and see how it works in practice and see how the market breathes. So in this video, I'll discuss a few things that happened that I found very interesting and that we can learn a lot from. A company that we analyzed, Hein Celestial, set to work board deal with activist investor, so probably it will be taken over. I think I recommended the stock when it was at the lows in the last 6 months. The stock is much higher up. Now, why didn't I invest? I recommended it, I made an analysis. Why didn't I invest? I didn't invest because the price earnings ratio was 15. So I didn't know if this will happen. There was a probability that this will happen, a takeover, but the price earnings ratio of 15 was giving me a 7% earnings return. So I say pass. If it would have been a earnings return of 10 or there was growth or something, then I would have invested. However, it was too risky for me. That's why I didn't invest. Now it will probably be taken over, so somebody wants to bet on a higher price. It can be in the short term. It will probably be taken over at 48.50, so there is still some upside. However, we don't know when it will be taken over. Something very interesting is Nike declared their earnings, and you can see the stock price dropped on the day of earnings. Let's see what happened. So flat sales growth, okay. However, revenue, Nike 2%, Converse was the main loss there, so something not going on with that brand. North America footwear sales fell 3%. The people in North America can't have a million pair of sneakers. You buy what you need, and so we can't expect much growth from North America. However, sales in China were up 12%. The market is domestic bias, behavioral finance, focused on North America. China is where the future is, and 1.5 billion people, 3 billion in Asia, will be wearing sneakers in the next 10-20 years as people in North America do. And that's where the value is and the growth is. Gross margin fell, unfavorable currency rates. That's not nice, but something to keep an eye on. Nevertheless, the growth online, the stability in the US will work well for Nike. Then, Nestle gives ground to billionaire Loeb, prioritizing profit. Now, Nestle is mostly owned by pension funds, thus short-term profits that Loeb wants to see, he wants to see higher stock price, are not good for long-term value creation. And let's see what's going on. Since Loeb disclosed the position, stock price is high, you can see in the last few months, from 68 to 85, 86. And now Nestle is going to sell 10 billion of assets of, let's like the US chocolate business, in order to buy back stocks as much as 20 billion francs, $21 billion. So the price earnings ratio is 27, the book value is 4.2, and they are going to use the money to push the stock price higher so that Loeb, a hedge fund manager, can make money now. Pension funds, me and you, if you own it through your pension fund, will get squeezed and there won't be any book value more to protect the company. There won't be any businesses more to make revenue, to grow earnings. So, shareholder destroying example in the making, Nestle and hedge funds. Emerging markets, fear from North Korea brought it down, declining. So, emerging markets, when people sense risk, they start to pull money from the exotic. So you always have to look at the fundamentals, what's going on, and look at uncorrelated assets. Investing with the herd will bring you to herd-like returns. So if you invest in the emerging market ETF here, it's very risky. ETFs like to buy hot stocks and not the best stocks. Thank you for watching. I hope you liked the weekly recap. We'll talk macroeconomics, we talk finances, we talk politics. You can expect every week a weekly recap. I'll see you in the next video.